Ladies and gentlemen, back to center ring here, about 9 of the evening. Proudly brought to you by Gobsmack Sports Mouthguards. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, here we go. Introducing first, fighting out of the Real Mark Red Corner. Proudly sponsored by LJ Hooker, Applecross, and LDL Settlements. Ladies and gentlemen, this is David the Closer.
With bout number 9, we have David La Rosa, sponsored by LJ Hooker, Applecross, and LDL Settlement, versus Ron Stein, sponsored by Forbes Kirby, and the belt sponsor, shout out to Gobsmack Mouthguard, and my co-commentator here, Troy McMillan.
Hi, mate, nice to see you. David's got a big following here tonight, I reckon.
You know these lads?
Yeah, I know both the guys. It's going to be a really good fight, I think.
Oh, excellent.
I think it's very evenly matched.
David does look in great shape.
And his opponent fighting out of the Studio 22 Blue Corner, proudly sponsored by Forbes Kirby Lawyers. Ladies and gentlemen, this is John the Smoke Bomb.
The smoke bomb.
I like it. I like the music too. Good entrance music. Crowd will get behind this.
The crowd loves it. Big crowd here tonight, I think.
Shout out to our sponsors, Studio 22, Brightside Live, Audio Visual Events, Real Mark, and Auto Productions Group. Event services and technical solutions.
So John represents Forbes Kirby Lawyers. Proudly on his chest. These guys are going to turn it on.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's coming up to 10 past 10. You've got less than 20
last instructions from the corners.
Your bidding ballots in for the silent auction here tonight.
What do you think they're saying right now?
Rumble, pick up the
it's tough call.
It's on your table. Fill it in. Make sure you get it to one of the staff wearing a gold tie.
Nigel's been
or
proposed all night.
Or pop it into one of the ballot boxes. It's all
Nigel.
Going to a good cause.
The intensity on Nigel's face. He wants this one.
As Bill said,
the hairs remain throughout the night, though. That's very impressive.
Yeah. I think the red corner needs this one to even it up
in
a little bit more.
Red corner, we've got the smoke bomb, John Stein.
What do you think? Is it 5-3, you reckon?
I think so.
Yeah. Be nice for the red to get this one.
All for bragging rights between Glenn and Nigel.
The judges are ready.
Here we go. Both fighters moving well.
John has a nice jab.
The closer, ducking and weaving.
He moves well. He moves very well.
Ducking down nicely. Closer jabbing.
As does David, though. David's been moving nicely.
Oh, both fighters up to the head, to the body.
John looks like a seasoned boxer right now.
I think that both these guys probably got the best looking skills I've seen all night.
I think so too, yeah.
There's a lot of intensity.
John's got some nice hand speed on him.
Both guys just trying to get their distance.
John's picking some nice shots. Jab to the head and going to the body. Very technical. Very beautiful.
Oh, nice body shot from John. Yeah, great body shot. David's bobbing and weaving, bobbing and weaving. Looking for an opening.
David's doing great in his own right, but John just seems a little bit more technical.
They do. Nice. I think you're right. Oh, another good body shot from John.
Well, if you're looking for a lawyer,
Forbes Kirby are the ones for you. David representing LJ Hooker.
Very nice fight so far. Very technical.
Yeah, I like this opening round. I really do. A lot happening out there. Both fighters very technical. Ooh, body shot from John.
I'm not sure if this is their first fight, but John looks like he's been here before.
It really does. These guys look good. Both of them look really very, very good. What a great first round.
I'm here with Cam Cranley, former Bachelorette star that we all know and love. Cam, what do you think of the fashion so far tonight?
Honestly, I think it one-ups itself every year. I think we say this every year, but the guys are outdoing themselves. They're all in tuxes this year. The women have incredible dresses. They've thought everything through. I'm really impressed, yeah.
Me too. Have you found any trends that are up there tonight?
I think that's the main thing, is the tuxes. Guys traditionally, for this event, have worn a lot of ties, and I think they're really upping it, and now it's kind of going to the tux style, which I really love.
I totally agree. Alrighty. Best dress coming up very soon.
Seconds out.
Round two. If we can match the first round intensity. Good jazz from David. Oh, these guys are really going at it.
Glenn calling for that right hook to the body. Let's see if he throws it. It's doubled up on the jab.
Good guard from David.
Nice body rip.
Oh, overhand left.
Good sportsmanship. The boys just break on their own. There we go.
Trying to get that distance. Another body shot from John.
He uses that jab so nicely.
He does, really nicely. Tell you what, round two hasn't slowed down. It closes up, good guard.
Not yet, I was about to say the same thing. Nice tight guard there by David.
Yeah. Bobbing and weaving again.
Again, shout out to Anarchy Training for training these guys. They look well prepared.
What a great job these guys do. Nigel Groves, Glenn Austin, and all the other staff on board. Oh, body shot. Oh, right in our corner. Not a knockdown. Just a slip.
Yeah,
just a slip.
Glenn Austin calling for the uppercut. Tell him to come forward. Trying to see if Nigel's what he's going to call out.
Red corner watching intensely. David started with a lead right. Ooh, big right then. Just missed though.
They're asking for the last push, 10 seconds. They're asking for a nice push from the blue corner.
This is a fantastic fight.
Even round this one.
Very even round.
Round two, probably brought to you by
I don't know what round that, who did you get that one to?
Alrighty, I'm going to hand over to the gorgeous Pim, who is announcing Best Dress this evening. Thank you, Beck. Everybody, we have the lovely Danny Jones here. Danny, please tell us what you're wearing tonight.
Meshy tonight. I'm a bit traumatized, like, thank you so much.
Give us a little twirl. And just quickly, how did you come to find this dress?
Last minute, online. I liked it, I bought it.
Well, you look absolutely stunning. Congratulations. And enjoy the little win of this evening.
What you know about rolling down in the deep? Seconds out, third and final round. Fighters for the center are into touch gloves.
Wow.
Here we go, round three.
Round three has been a fantastic fight.
Have you got it at the moment? One apiece?
Yeah, I reckon one apiece.
I heard Glennie in between rounds asking for the left hook after that right. So we'll see if...
Some big punches been thrown, none connecting at this stage. Both fighters still keeping their form.
Both still very active as well. Not
very, very active, moving a lot around the ring.
Stop it!
obviously getting tired, but they're still keeping their form.
Beautiful technique.
Yeah. Oh, nice uppercut from David. Sucking it in.
Oh, beautiful right hand. Oh, beautiful.
I think David connected with a right, but then John came back with some of his own. Oh,
such an even fight right now.
Jeez, I tell you, this is a fantastic fight. Uppercuts, straights.
They're throwing it all out there right now. Bit of a breather, bit of a respite, and then here we go, back into it again, boys.
John going with the hook.
Oh,
maybe.
Tip for tap.
Yeah, I think tip for tap that one. Both right hands.
Less than 30 seconds remaining.
A body shot from John.
Steinsy in the blue corner. La Russa in the red corner.
This is tough one to call. I hate to be a judge.
Who's going
to
come out? Oh, it's a good jab. Jab by David. Oh, a right hand by John. That could be telling. Final stages of the fight.
Oh, both of them.
They're all going hell for leather now.
Oh,
fantastic fight.
To the center of the ring, please. Bout 9 the evening is for the Gobsmack Mouthguards Championship belt, and we've got Kiara and Rob here from Gobsmack to present the winner with their title. After 3 rounds of action, we turn to the judges for their decision. Ladies and gentlemen, it is unanimous. Your winner, the Studio 22 Blue Corner, John the Smoke Bomb Star. With your Gobsmack Mouthguards champion, John the Smoke Bomb Steins. Now, mate, how are you feeling right now? It was a big, tough battle for you.
I'm absolutely gassed. That was a fantastic fight. Dave put on a great show today, so well done, brother. We've all trained really hard, so got to take my hat off to him.
Fantastic. Now, have you enjoyed your last weeks of training under the $6 million man?
Oh, absolutely. It's something different to what I'm used to, and to have Chris and Glenn in my corner has been the best, so big shout out to them.
Now, for anyone out there who's sitting in the crowd tonight and they're thinking that maybe they'd like to be here in centre ring, what advice have you got for them?
Bloody sign up and do it. It's the best thing you'll ever do.
All right, mate, one last thing. I'm sure you've got a few folks that you'd like to thank here tonight.
Yeah, well, obviously Glenn and Chris have been in my corner the whole way, and then all my teammates have been fantastic. We've been beating the shit out of each other the last couple of weeks, so we got each other prepared, so we've done it, and fantastic night.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, there we go. Your winner here, about nine of the evening here at the Gobsmack Perth Corporate Rumble, John the Smoke Bomb Stiles. And now we're going to Kyle in the crowd.
Thank you, CJ. We're here with Mitch, his Basie Football Club teammate. Are you happy with how he went, mate?
Yeah, mate, I've lost my voice during the signs here, but I was so proud of him. He fucking absolutely smashed it. Yeah, he's such a warrior. Just so happy for him. Deserves it.
He did deserve it. I think it was a pretty dominant performance. Considering you lost your voice, it sounded quite strong there. Anything else you'd like to say to Stinesy?
Wait, Stinesy! Stinesy!
I think that'll do. Back to you, CJ. Thank you.